Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss the poem My Mother at 66. That is the first poem of Standard 12 textbook Flamingo. Okay, this poem is written by a very famous Indian poet, Kamala Das, and she was born in Malabar, Kerala. In this poem, she discusses about how she is going from her parents' home in Cochin towards the airport, and during that whole car journey, she looks at her mother who is sitting beside her and sees that how her mother at the age of 66 has grown truly old, and this makes her realize that soon would be a time when she might lose her mother. Okay, and there are instances through the car journey itself that make her realize the fact that time is speeding by and she doesn't have enough time with her mother, right? So I'll start reading the poem stanza wise. Basically, the central idea, the theme of this poem is about separation, right? The pain, the fear of separation, that is the theme of this poem. And I'll start reading stanza wise and explaining. My mother at 66. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. So here the poet says that she is driving in a car from Cochin on that was last Friday. So the poem was written with reference to last Friday when she was driving from her parents' home in Cochin towards the airport. And that's the time that she looks at her mother who is sitting beside her. I saw my mother beside me, doze, open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was as old as she looked. So when she looks at her mother who is sitting beside her in the car seat, she looks at her and sees that she is dozing. That means she is, you know, old people that have a tendency to fall asleep while sitting, right? So she has dozed off, fallen asleep. And she's open-mouthed, okay? Her face ashen, like that of a corpse. See, when you are alive, or if you think of a newborn baby, for example, a child, a baby's face is rosy. It is full of the lush pink or the reddish color that is coming from underneath the skin, which signifies life, you know? But as a person grows older and older, the face becomes ashen. That means it becomes grayish, dullish. Right, it starts losing its life. So looking at her mother sleeping like that, dozing off like that with her mouth open and looking so old, she felt that she looked ashen faced like a corpse or like a dead body. Okay, but and the poetess realizes that she looked as old as she was, right? She was as old as she looked. That means she was looking very old and she really was that old, okay? But soon put the thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes. Now, this realization that her mother was very, very old makes her realize that soon she might die, right? And she looked already like a corpse. So this made her uncomfortable. This was an unpleasant feeling. So she looks out of the window. Instead of looking at her mother, she looks out of the window to put the thought out of her mind. And what does she see out of the window? She finds young trees sprinting. Now, sprinting means running. Okay. Now, trees don't run. But when trees are stationary and you are moving by a vehicle in a very fast movement, it looks like the trees are running in the other direction. So she sees the trees which are young and they are sprinting. The merry children spilling out of their homes, and she saw the children were rushing out of their homes as if like there were so many children and so many rushing out of their homes like some liquid is spilling out. Okay, so many young children were spilling out of their homes to play. So basically this is a contrast between her mother who looks almost dead as compared to the scene outside, which again reminds her, you know, the sprinting of the trees and the merry children which are spilling out, everything is in a fast motion, and those things remind her of youth and life as compared to her dead mother. So this is a contrast which makes her even more realize the fact that her mother is towards the end of her life. Okay, But after the airport security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her, then pale as a late winter's moon. Now, she didn't want to keep looking at her mother because her mother looked like a dead body, like somebody who was going to die soon or somebody who was almost dead. This wasn't a pleasant feeling. So she looked out of the window, but this scene outside the window again reminded her of that same fact, okay? But then when she was again at the security check of the airport, she looked at her mother again, right? And when she saw her mother again, what did she look like? She looked wan. That means she had a fading kind of color, a pale color on her face. Again, she says pale, as a winter's moon, as a late winter's moon. Now, the thing is, when it is late winter, it is quite cold and it is basically foggy. So, on foggy nights, you hardly see the moon. And even if you do see the moon, it is a very pale moon that has almost lost most of its radiance because of the fog, right? So, her mother looked like that pale winter's moon, which was in the late winter, that had lost its radiance. You know, as you grow older and older, you lose the radiance of your life as your life starts coming to an end. And again, she's reminded of that same fact that her mother probably didn't have much time to live longer. Okay? And I looked again at her wan, pale as a late winter's moon and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. Now, looking at her again at the security check and again realizing that her mother was old and probably soon going to die, she was reminded of a familiar childhood ache and fear. What was that fear? As a child, every child has faced the fear of losing their parent, right? You do not see a very young child when they do not see their parent for even a moment's time, they may start crying, they may have, you know, they want to be clingy, they want to be touching the cloth of the mother or holding the finger or something on the other. So this is every child's fear, but for the poetess, this must have been more of it. And she is reminded of that fear that she used to have long back in her earlier childhood, that of losing her mother. And this now comes back to her, that same pain, that same fear of losing her mother. And now this would be something forever because soon her mother would eventually die. Yeah. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile and smile and smile. But she doesn't want her mother to realize that she's feeling that pain or that ache, or she has realized that her mother would soon die. She doesn't want her mother to realize the pain that she's going through. She doesn't want to put her through that agony. Okay, so all she does was, she just waved at her. She says, see you soon, Amma. Okay, to emphasize the fact to herself probably that maybe she might not see her ever again, probably. She says, see you soon, Amma. And then all she did was smile and smile and smile. She kept on smiling. Also because she did not want her mother to realize the pain that she was feeling, the fear that she was feeling. Also to put on a brave face to herself that no, nothing is going to happen. I'll see her again. That positivity. Okay, so she keeps on smiling and smiling and smiling. And that's the end of it. Basically, the poem, again, I'll repeat the same thing. It is about the fear and the pain of separation. Okay? That's it. Thank you.